In this webisode, I describe some of the strategies I use when beginning a figure drawing. Each of the drawings you're about to see were done in 40 minutes, and they represent what I like to have set up before moving to more complex ideas. Hopefully, by cutting between three drawings, you'll be able to see how these strategies are applicable to poses of any kind. I begin by taking off a top and a bottom on the page. I then measure a half between those two points and on the model. In poses like this seated one, the top and the bottom are offset. Sometimes it's easier to do a horizontal plumb from the bottom to a point in the environment that lines up on a vertical axis with the head, then measure a half from there. Because the width is greater than the height in a reclining pose, I'll tick off each side and find a half between. Before I start my envelope, I take note of what overlaps the contour at the halfway point. This helps me judge my initial tilts and their lengths. To begin, I imagine 6 to 7 tilts around the whole of the figure and the shape or envelope they form. I then task myself simply with drawing that shape within the framework I've already established. As I advance to breaking down the envelope to smaller tilts, I always think back on that optical illusion that consists of two faces in a vase in the middle. Imagining in a similar way the negative shapes on either side of this figure gives me a better grasp of the tilts that make them up. I try to see these shapes and block their tilts in sequentially. This can be very helpful in a reclining pose when the body can be somewhat abstracted from what we typically expect. Seeing rhythms from tilts across the figure help us begin to tie both sides of the figure together. As elements of the figure begin to take shape, I can take very specific comparative measurements to see how things are adding up. As I move forward, I again reflect on the optical illusion of the vase. I now task myself with drawing the positive shape that makes up the figure. Now that I have a rough contour placement of all of the parts, I can run a series of plumb lines to make sure that I have a consistent pose left to right. Now I can break the contour down further, taking large tilts and subdividing them to reflect more closely the contour I see in life. Knowing the proportion of the head enables me to divide the shape of the hair mass and the mask of the face. I can also move through the figure and begin to comfortably fit in light-dark shapes that make up the light effect. Visualizing these as abstracted shapes offers a view of these events that's objective from your understanding of the figure. With a few more additions, I've now completed the first 40 minutes of my figure drawing. I'll be back soon with part 2. Thanks, everyone.